shop owner has bought in the Santa or any light bazaar.
Ek hi jagah pe milke. Those type of plastics are known as thermosetting plastics. Comparison, there are three types.
Up, down, right, left.
I am not inferior to anyone.
You are clever. You are top on the hour. Congratulations.
I want to be a leader.
A very good morning to all the RCs, DCs, principals, and all the staff, and our little swallows. Very good morning to all of you. Welcome to this show for the first of its kind in academic year. Address of our secretary to all the staff and students. I'm so happy that our secretary is addressing all of you to giving us a new energy to carry on till the end of this academic year. So, sir, welcome to you, sir. Welcome to you, sir, for today's program.
Thank you.
And welcome to Geetha Lakshmi, ma'am, our DS Academics. And also with me, Rupa Devi, ma'am, DS Academics. And Mr. Sudhakar.
Thank you.
From DS Academics from Tribal Welfare. Sir, this new academic year, I am sure that we have many programs. We have been here and there, at least we have some kind of respite in the busy schedule. But you have been traveling without rest all these years, and you are still continuing. And you are again coming out with new academic initiatives. How do you get this energy, first of all? That's my first question to you for this year.
I think it's a very good question. Students are the secret of my energy. So I have gained a lot of energy. So this year is going to be a very special year for me, because I will be finishing 5 successful years in this social welfare residential school society. So on July 4th of this year, I will be completing 5 years. And second most important thing is I'll be touching 50 years of my age this year.
But these
Sveros, all the students of social welfare and tribal welfare residential schools, so they have made me so younger. Even today, I feel that I'm just a 20 years old guy. So students are the secret of my energy. So once I see them, I get all my energies back, and then I feel like, you know, zooming ahead to the bright and brilliant future.
Right, sir. Rightly said. I think you have set the tone for the today's program, as well as you have set the tone for our new academic year. So, coming back to our summer program, sir, mm-hmm. I think it was a very massive one we have undertaken. What is your opinion on that summer programs?
I think Summer Samurai has been brilliant, fantastic, and very meticulously planned till the last detail. And Summer Samurai, as many as 80% of the students have participated in Summer Samurai. And then I have very fond memories of Summer Samurai this year. Like I participated in cooking, in hotel management, and I participated in horse riding, then robotics, and voice for girls, young leadership, whatnot. So every department, every domain of activity in which our students have participated has been extremely brilliant, extremely memorable. So, and similarly, the most of the teachers also have participated in Summer Samurai, and then in summer. In fact, this summer has been more busier than the regular academic year, because this summer I have seen entire head office working day and night to make every student very comfortable, and then to make every student gets most of the experience that he or she would have made in a Summer Samurai campaign. So this Summer Samurai has been extraordinarily, you know, memorable.
Yeah, correct, sir. Yes. And some of students participate. I think around 30,000 children participated in the Summer Samurai camps.
Mm-hmm.
And all the students are now participating in Summer Samurai projects. So, what do you say about the projects?
I'm really excited to see the Summer Samurai projects, because last year Summer Samurai projects, I still remember, they were so colorfully made and then much better than many university students. Like, I still remember a Summer Samurai project done by a Sirpur girls school student, similarly a Summer Samurai project done by a Palakurti student. So when we brought those Summer Samurai project notebooks to Telangana State Police Academy to be shown to our Honorable Deputy Chief Minister. So I was really amazed to see all those brilliant projects made by the students, and then the kind of detail they have gone into. So they have gone into the deeper parts which great intellectuals also would not have gone. So that is a kind of brilliance that our people have showed on the ground. And this year, I'm really excited to see all the Summer Samurai projects. I don't get even sleep. So all these Summer Samurai projects will be coming into my dreams. And then I would like to see that dream girl and then dream boy.
Yeah, yes. I'm sure that they have some incentives are waiting for them.
Absolutely.
All the outstanding students as well.
Absolutely. Not only Summer Samurai projects, and this year we're planning to have a wonderful excursion for all these students. We are planning to have a Bharat Darshan. So we will be selecting the students based on their performance in Summer Samurai projects. Brilliant super students and green gurus and the people who have done exceedingly well on sports, craft, and the people who have done extremely well in Summer Samurai projects as well, Summer Samurai camps as well. Then the people who have done very well in academics, particularly in the first years, and the 10th graders who have joined us, and all those 9th graders, whatnot. So the people who have excelled in other departments also. So all these people will be bunched, and then based on their leadership skills, and based on their extracurricular activities, and based on their responsibility, sense of responsibility in the schools. So all these people will be graded and then bunched into 5 different groups. So we will be sending these 5 different groups into 5 different parts of the country. So one group will go to North India, another group will go to South India, then third group will go to East India, and fourth will go to West, and then the fifth one will go to center. Then East Indian group might also go towards Andaman Nicobar Islands. So this is what we are planning, and then one department is seriously working on making all the last minute arrangements for all the children, and then this is going to be the exciting affair. Similarly, all those children who have been doing extremely well in their schools, so those people also will be taken to local tours this year. So we are making plans for local tours as well. So this is going to be literally a great liberation for all the students, both the social welfare and tribal welfare residential schools and colleges. So
yes, I think apart from academics, they are also something to look forward. They can explore other avenues as well.
See, academics is good, but sitting in the classroom and then looking at the blackboard and reading the books and then evening study hours are all fine. But you must make sense out of what you read. Like, I read 10 books, I read 2 books a day, and I make out something out of those books. But I should know how to use that knowledge on the ground. Whether the thing that I am learning in the classrooms or the textbooks, whether it is useful in real life or not, that I should be able to test. So always 24 hours sitting in the classroom will not help. I am not a great fan of sitting in the schools every time and doing it in the four walls of classroom. So we should get out of the classroom, we should get out of the schools with, of course, proper precautions. So, and then we should see whether the things that we are learning are really useful in our life or not. So that's what is the key for learning.
Sir. And before we stepping into the this academic year, I think we have a wonderful success last year.
Yes.
So could you enumerate a few success stories of our Swaros because of the collective effort of the teachers and all the people are concerned?
Yeah. So our teachers really worked very hard, and then this year, last year, it was absolutely amazing effort by all the teachers. They left their families behind, and then they adopted all the children as their extended family. and the results have been really scintillating, and the 10th class results almost touched 90%, and then intermediate results were almost 85%, and we have been consistently ahead of state averages. Like, we are almost 15% above the state average in every department, and then our degree colleges, particularly the residential degree colleges for women, social welfare degree college, they made us super proud. Like, you know, the university's average was hovering around 30%, and then our average was hovered around 80%. So that is a phenomenal success. Like, even Honorable Chief Minister or K. Chandrasekhar Rao garu also has mentioned time and again that residential degree colleges have made us really proud. Not only residential degree colleges, even the institutions, both tribal welfare and social welfare. And this year, in fact, our Chief Minister has consented to give 21 residential degree colleges for tribal boys and girls. And he has also asked me to prepare proposals for residential degree colleges for social welfare boys, as well as some more residential schools in the constituencies where the population of marginalized sections is more. So another thing I wanted to share with you on this note, that this year, thanks to our Geeta Lakshmi and other people, so we have been successful enough to start one social welfare residential school for fine arts. So all those people who are willing to sing, all the people who are interested to dance, and all those people who are interested to, play music, instrumental, Hindustani, Western, classical, and theater arts, and then whatnot. So painting, drawing, all these people have been selected, and then they will be brought to Social Welfare Residential School for Fine Arts in Malkajgiri. So this is a great, this is one of the best feathers in our, cap, which is already very heavy.
Yes, yes.
Then similarly, the success in IITs and NITs has been phenomenal. Then tribal welfare has surpassed our expectations. And at this time, tribal welfare, one of the beautiful things in tribal welfare is, thanks to Sudhakar and all his colleagues and all the principals in the on the ground, and particularly IIT Rajendranagar, and then, Adilabad, and then SOE Khammam, and the COE Warangal. So we have had wonderful results. Like, the state 12th ranker is from our students, and 25 students from tribal welfare, another 7 to 8 students from social welfare, and all put together around 100 students will be joining IITs and NITs. What more do you need? And similarly, 26 people have joined Ajim Premji University so far, and then we are still expecting many more students to join medicine and engineering, and particularly the medicine NEET results are yet to come. And this time, three people are going to join the National Law University, and then one of the girls said, it's still ringing in my ears, that she wants to become Supreme Court judge. Yes. It's something amazing. Earlier, our girls used to aspire to become nurses. Our people used to aspire to become, the drivers and conductors. And today, see where they have gone. Yes. They have gone as high up to Supreme Court Chief Justice. So at a very young age, if a girl who is born in a godforsaken tanda or a colony, and today she is aspiring to become a Supreme Court Chief Justice, the very knowledge and the aspiration has gone beyond our roof.
Yeah.
So this is something which is extremely memorable, and then I have no words. For example, in Samar Samurai campaign, the boys who have undergone training with us, like a boy called Estish from BC Welfare Society. So this boy has got 16th rank in Telangana state LASET entrance examination, getting 16th rank in open category. Around 20 to 30 people are going to join, law in open category. What more you need? So social welfare and tribal welfare, they are zooming ahead. I know there are a lot of problems on the ground, but okay, so problems make you very tough. So, but we are not sparing even a, we are not leaving any stone unturned to make the life of our, Sveros extremely comfortable. What I did not get as a student, I am trying my best with the help of all these people who are sitting with me to make the life more comfortable for all of you.
Yes, and yeah. Sveros was also into EFLU, English and Foreign Language,
yes,
Universities, and
yes,
Central University as well.
See, Sveros not only into English and foreign language, Sveros have gone into Bollywood now.
Yes, exactly.
So, Sveros now, Purna is a movie, Purna is a Bollywood movie. It has been shown in 400 theatres across the country. Even now, it is available on Amazon Prime Video. Almost 1 lakh people may have viewed this movie all over the world. So, in every frame in Purna movie, you find a word called Sveros and then 10 Commandments. So now Purna, the movie has taken you to all countries in this world. So what more do you need?
Yes.
As a
yes, that thing, there is no limit for the Swaros aspirations, as all of us know. And I hope all the Swaros will take clues from these successful Swaros and get inspired by them. Sir, this is academic achievements, and what about the sports achievements?
Sports achievements.
I'm sure that we also have
sports.
Some
yeah, sports achievements have been phenomenal. Like recently, we had the social welfare residential school student, participating in a handball competition, and then he got gold medal in a national level. So he represented Telangana state team, and then he got gold medal. Similarly, in yoga, people have been doing extremely well, and then this time mountaineering again, we did not give up, and then we had sent our people to Manali. And on the sidelines, let me also mention that inspired by Purna and Anand's success, so 14 students of Andhra Pradesh also have scaled Mount Everest. This is a huge thing. This year, 10 people died on while scaling Mount Everest. But our Swaros, they have from Andhra Pradesh, they have scaled Mount Everest successfully, and they told us that they have got inspired so much from Purna and Anand. So that is something which is really memorable on sports department. And this year we are planning to set up gyms in every school, particularly the girls and boys schools, and gyms in degree colleges as well. And we are also planning to make chess as compulsory game in all the schools, so that our people also can give some exercise to their brains as well. And we know that not everyone can play the games. So all those people who may not be able to play the games, all those people, we are Geeta Lakshmi and Rupa Devi and all the head office, and including you. So these people have created some activities on the sidelines, so that our people can practice theater, can watch some movie, and then can criticize the movie, can come up with a report on the movie. And similarly, eco-friendly clubs, and then similarly, radio, school radios, all those things Geeta Lakshmi has been planning, and then it has been properly communicated to all the schools.
Yes, sir. And also we have a FIDE master as well in chess.
Yes, Laya.
Yeah.
Laya made all of us proud. Then she got, FIDE master, and this is very unusual for the girl who is born and brought up in Mahabubnagar district, and then she went up to FIDE masters and online. So we gave us a nice tablet which costs about 15,000 rupees, so that she can play games.
Yes.
On her own.
Yes.
So similarly, our honorable minister Sri Jagdish Reddy Garu, he gave lot of prizes to all super students, and particularly the girls like Kavya and other girls from RKpuram and other girls from other schools. So a lot of good things are happening, and then I also congratulate all the teachers and then the principals who have got felicitated by honorable minister Sri Jagdish Reddy Garu and Chandilal Garu on the event of this success. Similarly, in tribal welfare, we could give laptops and 50,000 rupees to those students who have cracked IITs and NITs, and shortly in social welfare also we will be giving this year from our minister. So, yeah.
Let me tell all the viewers that we have heard our secretary speaking about the success story of Aswarus. All this is because of the efforts we all have put in collectively. Now, coming to the new academic initiatives, let me ask Geeta Lakshmi ma'am. The first thing is academics, or of course, that is our forte.
Yes.
And this is about the new academic initiative called Flipped Classes. What would you like to say about the Flipped Classes to all the viewers today?
Yes. Regarding Flipped Classes, churning has started. And last year itself, we have declared that we are going to start Flipped Classes. And this year, we have intensified it. And we have conducted a workshop at head office level, and teachers really wonderfully, they have performed Flipped Classes. We were afraid whether they were able to do it or not. We were afraid really, but wonderfully they have performed. We were very much overwhelmed by their performance.
Mm.
And so we have started workshops also. So we want to spread that Flipped Class to all schools. So we have started workshops, and two workshops we have already completed, languages and social studies and other subjects, science, mathematics, and like that in tribal welfare also.
Yes.
They have conducted, and now we want to take them to the classroom. Take them to the classroom. So it is starting. Some of the teachers, they felt that it is a new method. They can't do like that. They felt, but after listening to that, after seeing the demos of other teachers, they felt it is very easy. They can do it very easily in the classroom. And what they have to do is they have to engage the students. The students will perform. They have to trigger discussion in the classrooms, and students will take over the discussion, and they will be knowing many things. We also can learn so many things from their lives and all. So, flipped class is a wonderful, I think, wonderful. This year we are going to do that wonderful thing, and we will become the role models to other schools also.
Private
and corporate, everyone.
Private and corporate, it is not there in private schools, but we are starting it. So, from the academic, starting of the academic year, we have taken this initiation and we have started that. And some myths teachers have regarding these flipped classes. By the workshops, we have clarified all their doubts about flipped classes. I think you all know, in all classrooms, I think in all staff rooms, this is a discussion from the first day itself regarding flipped classes. And I think you all can start doing, taking these classes, and you can see the wonderful results of that class, of that this method of teaching of flipped classes, and you will enjoy it.
That is a very good academic initiative, I think. As usual, we are the pioneers in every program, and if we are continuing with this, I think we will make history.
Definitely.
Together with all of us, we will make history on that. I am so proud that we are associated with such a teaching learning strategy called flipped classes. Now, ma'am, to Rubadev ma'am, now we have heard about flipped classes. Now, another new initiative what we have had taken last year is Life Skill Studios,
yes,
wherein we teach the basic life skills to the students in the form of, you know, TOT trainings, training masters, and they in turn impart training to the students.
True.
Now, would you say something about the Life Skill Studios which we are just started 2 days ago?
2 days ago, we have started a Life Skill Studio at in Nalagonda district. We started,
yes,
with two schools, sir,
yes,
and today I think it is going on in Adilabad,
Jaipur.
So I think it is only the refinement of personality of a child, how he has to use the ethics, and how he has to grow up in life with right values. So I think that environment which gives him a personality development, we are taking care of that, sir. And teachers are going to come to that Life Skill Studio, and they are going to take the inputs from the people who are training, and again in every institution this is going to spread, sir.
Yes, yes.
So I think that is the purpose of having it here there, and I think we are spending a lot of money on that, so everybody has to take it in the right spirit and see that it is implemented and grounded properly, sir.
Yes, I think it is our secretary's initiative, Life Skill Studios. So I would like to ask you, what was in your mind when you started something called Life Skill Studio, and why the strange name called studios?
See, George, one thing I have had the opportunity of visiting about 23 countries in this world. I've been telling all our students that I was born and brought up in Nalamala forest area where I could see the electricity only in my eighth grade, but I had the rare opportunity of visiting 23 countries. What I found in these countries, I want to share with you. See, the greatest thing that can happen to that I have visited in these countries is their bathrooms. Very surprising, their toilets. Their toilets are so clean, they're so dry. They're as dry and as clean as your, bedrooms and then other rooms. They treat their toilets as temples. So that is number one. Number two, they don't throw things around. In this summer, I had visited so many homes of our Sweros as a part of Quest program. And when I entered our Sweros homes, everything was strewn around. So there is no method in putting the things properly. And even if there are tables, even if there is some space, our swearers could have put these things properly. And in simple things like folding the bed sheet, folding the blankets and keeping the pillow in right position, and you know, drying the closet properly without you know, any disorder or asymmetry. And that aesthetic sense, that sense of hygiene, sanitation, orderliness was totally missing in our homes. And then it happens to many homes as well, not necessarily all our swearers, even in our home also it happens. So, but we make a conscious effort every other day to put things in proper order, to put things in proper, you know, arrange them in a proper fashion, so that the ambience, that the right ambience gives you right thoughts, provokes right thoughts. So, the life skill studio and the way you communicate, the way you take care of your room, the way you sit in your class, the way you take care of your bathrooms and latrines will decide what kind of person you are going to be in future. That is what I have understood. So, you go to any Western, I studied in the best possible university in this world, Harvard University. 100 to 200 people use the same toilet, but toilet will be as dry as it starts on the day one, on the first hour of the day. So, they do not soil the toilets. In our schools, many schools which I found, then write all filthy language on the toilets, A. Then they do not clean the toilets once they use it, particularly in the boys' schools, I am very sorry to say this. So, and in boys' schools, they break the doors of the toilets. For whom are we doing this? Whose property is this? In one school, just because principal had seized the mobile phone cameras, mobile phones of the students, and 10 to 15 students, they go on rampage and then they break all the doors of the toilets. Then whose property is this? That sense of responsibility must be there in all the students. That's because school is your property. School is like temple. School is like sanctum sanctorum. Me intlo garbhagudi ye vidhanga untundo, me intlo devunni pettukoni ye vidhanga poojistaro, school aa garbhagudi kanna important anna vishayam prati vidyarthiki prati teacher kuda artham kavali. Today I got a message that none of the teachers have attended prayer program in one of the schools. What kind of life is this? What are we trying to tell the world? So, this is not what we want from our students, because other day Geeta Lakshmi and I, Rupa Devi and you know, Shema, three of us, we went to an army selection camp. So, the people who are selecting army officers, they said they have seen about 100 students of ours. You know what they shared really brought tears in my eyes, because I do not cry, so I did not cry. So, what they said, your children do not know anything beyond your schools, A. B, your children do not know a simple thing called using hanky. When they are sweating, they do not know how to use a handkerchief and then clean their face. When they are sneezing, they do not know how to dispose the mucus. So, when they come out, they do not know how to shave their beards. I am talking about boys, I do not know about girls. Okay. So, you do not know what are the different hairstyles, you do not know how to walk, you do not know how to sit, you do not know how to continue a conversation, you do not know how to eat. Because in the coming days, people are going to select you not on the basis of your deeper knowledge, because knowledge is already available. People are going to select you for a job or for a business or for a marriage or for anything for that matter, how you conduct yourself in front of others. How do you lead people? How do you eat your food? In couple of schools, I saw a lot of wastage in the schools. Why are you wasting this food? On one hand, farmers are committing suicide, and farmers are the people who are toiling in the, you know, on the fields, and then they are giving us food, and the same food is being wasted in social welfare and tribal welfare schools. You do not know how to dispose an eggshell. Tomorrow, if somebody wants to give you a job, he will not ask you any questions. Come, let us have food together. And he will put one fork, and then he will put one spoon, and then one knife, and then he will put one omelette or some bread there, then start, let us start eating. So, while eating, they will test you whether you eat properly or not, whether you make noise while eating, whether you put so much of food at one go, is something which people are going to look at. So, to avoid all these things, and some people in some cases, people will come to your home. If I want to give you a job, I want to see your home. How you maintain your bathroom? How you maintain your bedroom? How you maintain your drawing room? How you put your books in proper order? So these are the things people are going to look into, because knowledge is available all over the world. Now it is available very widely, freely on internet. What really matters is how you conduct yourself as a good human being. Is something, how punctual you are, how punctual you are. So these are the things that the people will be, who will be giving us jobs or who will be inviting for business, will be looking into. So to avoid all these things, to teach our students the best possible habits, I thought personally that I should start Life Skill Studios. Luckily you brought some people. So, and I think this Life Skill Studio should be helping us. And similarly, we will also be conducting a lot of sessions on how to conduct oneself, how to speak, how to continue a conversation for a longer time. We will be teaching in Mana TV as well. So,
yes,
this
are part of life skills.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're all basic life
skills. Yes. Absolutely, absolutely.
I'm sure that Swaros are going to benefit immensely. And together with the Swaros, I'm sure that, because I experienced Life Skills Studios training last year and this year, I think it is going to help all our teachers as well.
No, in fact, teachers also, because I saw a lot of teachers who came for principal's interview without shaving their beards.
Yes, yes.
So, what kind of, even for the women as well, so if you come in Punjabi dress, the impression of the interviewer will dramatically change.
Yes.
So, if you come with a proper formal sari, with the proper colors, not gaudy colors, proper sober colors, then the interviewer will change his opinion, his or her opinion dramatically. That's what is told in Life Skill Studio.
Yes,
so,
exactly.
How you dress, how you address people, and then how you sit, and then how you talk, will decide how much salary you are going to get in the job.
Exactly. Yeah. Yes. And Mr. Sudhakar sir, are you also having these flipped classes and Life Skill Studio
Before you talk to Sudhakar has just come back from Germany, so I would really appreciate if he can speak for a couple of minutes on his experience in Germany.
Yes.
How punctual Germans are,
yes.
Tell me.
that's a good question.
Sir,
yes, yes.
Sir, thank you for the opportunity given by the Secretary, sir. With his blessings, sir, I could be able to visit Germany. It's my one-time, lifetime achievement. So, actually, what I found, sir, is a very promptness, sir. Even seconds of promptness is there in the Germany people. And the next is the neatness and discipline. That three factors which I found, sir, as already you told me that, the toilets and everything also, very, very, what you said is 100% experienced by me, sir.
Including public toilets.
Including public toilets. So, you know, including the transporters in the buses and trains also, transporters, the toilets are very, very, we cannot imagine that type of maintenance in the transport vehicles. So, this is a wonderful experience for me, sir. And also, I visited a couple of schools there. I found some education systems and the students have been giving what is our idea of introducing the preparatory class is the visionary secretary, sir. Is nothing but taking place at there. I have been inspired for that, visiting that institutions. So, I could able to share my experience with the guidance of our secretary, sir, in our institutions. Regarding the 15 class, already our institution have been started the classes in the our institutions. Classes are conducting by our teachers. There is a positive response from our students and also teachers. At present, we don't face any problems. Students have been very much actively participating. In the coming days also, we'll take up some more project. The secretary sir, every year visionary secretary sir is introducing very new method of innovations in the institution. Like our teachers are usually habituated to the traditional conventional way of teaching. Last year it was the NQP. This year it was the preparatory class. So. It is a very good initiatives which are been taken up by our sir. So, there is a lot of positive response from the students as well as the other communities, parents and other in the communities people also. They have given the response because you have been introduced. So, that our most of huge demand for the admissions in our institutions only just because of introducing that like this type of programs in our institutions, especially in tribal level, there is a lot of competition and demand in the institutions. like that this time after in the instead of Gurukulam, we have been able to achieve this AIIMS and also IITs and medicines with the leadership and guidance of Secretary sir. We are thankful for that.
Thank you, Mr.
being with us.
Yes, I want to say something. So leadership makes a lot of change. So because of our leader, there is a lot of change in us, and that reflects in schools and society also. This time we received many applications for fifth class, and for backlog vacancies we have only 3,000 to 4,000 vacancies, but we received 40,000 applications.
Very nice.
That speaks the how our schools are functioning.
Yes, sir.
The demand for our schools.
Yes.
Demand for our schools.
Exactly. So every day we are seeing about 300 people visiting our office for admissions, but unfortunately we don't have vacancies. So Geeta Lakshmi is signing almost 100 to 200 papers every day. So but we don't have vacancies at all. So that is a kind of trust people have in the the political support that is given, that is being given by our honorable chief minister and our ministers Sri Chandulal garu and Jagdish Reddy garu. So we have been able to get as many applications as possible, and then nowhere you see an advertisement. Many corporate institutions, they put full page advertisement. We don't spend money on advertisement. We spend money on giving good food, good education, and good security to our children. And then I fully agree with Geeta Lakshmi. This time, for 40,000 seats in all departments, we have received about 2 lakh applications. It is phenomenal for residential schools. Yeah.
Yes, and we have started our academic year with flipped classes. Now, are you also planning to have some assignments to the students?
Yes, yes.
And would you talk about that? How do we go about?
Definitely. Yeah. I'm very eager to talk about, tell them about those assignments.
Okay.
So, first, before that, I want to tell you one thing. As a leader made lot of change, as a leader in the school also, principal and teachers, we expect that that you have to bring lot of change in the school. That's why we want to start this time assignments. Assignments, we have given a circular. For preparing a circular, we'll be spending lot of time, discussion, a discussion with the teachers, discussion with other society people, the discussion with educationist. After discussing, after only we are preparing those circulars. I request all the principals and all teachers and JLs, please go through that circular. Assignments for intermediate and first year and second year students, fortnightly you have to prepare some topics for assignments in all subjects, all lessons, topic wise you have to prepare assignments, and you have to allot those assignments to the students. You make students, 5 students a group, and allot them a assignment. In a group they will prepare for that assignment, and you have to give resources also. What are the books they have to refer, what are the things they have to do, and interviews, they can go outside and they can take interviews also for to prepare these assignments, and they have to present the assignments fortnightly. So this is not within the academic, your syllabus only. First start with your syllabus, afterwards we can extend it to further also. First start with you will be thinking again a new thing, again assignments, our syllabus will not be completed, but this is within your syllabus only. You have to prepare a list of topics which should be given to students for as assignments, and I think we are very serious about this. Whenever we will visit your schools, we will be definitely looking into those assignments. So I request all the principals and JLs start preparing a list of assignments which we should give to students.
And we also have weekly tests.
Yes.
Would you say something about weekly tests as
so
well?
So our academic calendar, we have already it is on our website. Please go through the academic calendar. We have taken lot of time, lot of manpower, lot of discussions to prepare this academic calendar thoroughly. In that we have given weekly tests also we are conducting, and our secretary he gave a very wonderful solution. Many teachers asked, if we conduct weekly test, how can we correct? That is the major question by the teachers. He gave us one solution that you can use teacher assistants, and with the help of teacher assistants you can do correction. Recently one of our staff member, she went to states, we have sent her to states, Sunita, and after coming back I asked her what is the procedure, how they will do this. She told me that they will give assignments, madam, they won't keep on teaching in the classroom, they will give assignments and students will prepare and come back. Then I asked her how they will correct. No madam, they won't correct, they will take the help of teacher assistants and they will correct. So like that, you can take the help of teacher assistants, you can correct those papers. And we have given a schedule and a timetable for a weekly test, what day, which subject should be conducted, like that. You please go through the academic calendar and you have to conduct a weekly test to the students.
Yes ma'am, thank you ma'am, that's very good information as far as academics is concerned. As all of us know that our Swaros are the news makers, the from our talk you already understand that most of you are news makers. Let me ask our secretary, sir, can we take a step further on Swaro news, and how can we go about it?
Yeah, I think last every year and every day lot of things are happening in our welfare residential schools, be it tribal welfare, be it social welfare, and be it degree colleges and so on and so forth, and then so many things may be happening in our villages as well. So, but these things are not known to all the student community in the schools and colleges. So this year we will be starting a Swaro news bulletin, where we will be collecting news at a centralized point from various regional points, and then we will be sending that bulletin well in advance to schools, and so that in the prayer these students, one of the students can read out the Swaro news that is happening in all our schools. So that is what Swaro news is all about. Then second thing is we will be requesting all the students who have undergone this young journalist camp for the last 3 years. So these people have to contribute something to the Swaro's magazine. For every article we will be spending some money, for we will be giving a money as reward to the students if they write a wonderful article about their personal experiences, about the things that they see in the school, and the things that inspired them. So those things, if you can share with us in writing, we will be publishing. If there, if those writings are qualified enough to join the Swaros magazine, then we will be definitely paying some honorarium to the students per article. So if it is 500 words, we will be paying something to the students. So this is something which we have started this year. That is Swaro News. Yeah, yeah.
That's all. Now let's go back to again Geeta Lakshmi about a little more academics,
okay,
because that is our strong point.
Yes.
This we have wanted to focus this year, ma'am. Together with, you know, assignments and weekly tests and all that, I think we are planning to have conducting a quiz as well, because our secretary is a big fan of not academics but co-scholastic activities.
Yes.
So it's part of our co-scholastic activities quiz. Yes, ma'am.
I think you all have gone through the timetable which was given to you. Last 1 hour we have allotted, Monday and Tuesday we have allotted for E plus club, and you can use the, as we have given 1 hour, you can use it for W plus also. And Wednesday and Thursday we have given for M plus and P plus, both you can conduct, both days both you can conduct, so that many mathematics and science teachers can personally they can supervise the classes. And on Friday we have allotted for quiz 1 hour, 1 hour quiz. Don't think that we are going beyond our syllabus. Take questions from the, we have given a circular on this quiz also, please go through that. And many rounds are there in that quiz, and subject teachers, they have to give their questions to the social studies teachers and class teachers. They will conduct this quiz, and it will be very useful to the students, and for easy for the teachers to also, they will remember one, it that question comes in the quiz, they will remember it forever. So this this will help them a lot, students a lot. So quiz is going to be a very wonderful the part of our timetable this time. So Friday 1 hour, 1 hour is a 60 minutes, means it's a very long time. So you can conduct it class wise, you can conduct wonderfully, and for that, for everything we need preparation. So plan well for that. Quiz means 1 week before itself you have to plan that what are the topics you are going to give, and the student should also prepare. We have already 4 houses. You can divide them into 4 houses, and you can conduct this quiz, and you have to prepare 1 week before itself and announce them what you are going to ask, which topics you are going to ask in the quiz, and they will come prepared with that. Lot of competition will be there, and you can give them gifts also, and display their names on the notice board. That will be encouraging this thing to them, students, and groups also. 4 houses are there, no? That house will be encouraged. So I request all the teachers and principals, we will be visiting on every Friday. Definitely we are going to visit the schools, and we want to see the jubilant, vibrant classrooms, especially on Fridays from 3:30 to 4:30.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. That's a very good information. I think you are mentioning about E+, and I think I would like to ask our secretary to kindly elaborate more on E+ activities, because I am sure that we all experience the power of E+.
Yes.
If our students are speaking well, the all credit goes to the E+ activities. I am sure that you will agree with me. So, could you elaborate on the E+? Is there any change in E+ activities this year?
Yeah, I think this year E+, you see all together a different format. So E+, earlier it used to be only a speaking, but this year it will be debating, and we will be giving you the contentious issues on which the entire class will be divided into 2 groups, and then they will be fighting with each other verbally in English. So based on some of the points that they elicit during their preparation. So we will be asking whether cell phones are a bane or boon. So can cell phones be allowed into the classroom? Then if he says it should be allowed into the classroom, then another half will say it should not be allowed into the classroom. And then they will be putting across their perspectives in English, and it will involve as many students as possible, and then that will help the acquisition of language in a much efficient way than it has been in the last 4 years. So that is English version 2. Then similarly, in addition to that, this year I am very happy to announce that we will be reviving English Doctor, because we have been watching, you are really struggling a lot to pick up good English, and unfortunately you have been partially successful. So one of the reasons is you have not been exposed to correct English. So to avoid these kind of imperfections and to overcome these imperfections, we are introducing English Doctor again. So this time some of our teachers like Padmaja, and then 3-4 others, and some of the people from outside who have been able to help you for the last 2 to 3 years, who have been helping you. So those people will be coming to Mana TV studio, and then they will be talking about how to speak stylish English language and perfect English language. For example, even today our people use simple present tense after using will. For example, I will thinks, I will does, I will goes. So then, for example, tenses, there is a problem, and those problems also will be corrected, and then some people will say I will come yesterday. So it is very normal, because English is not our mother tongue, so we don't have to worry about that. And then you have been speaking phenomenally good English. I spoke to a lot of people. Like other day I met a girl called Lakshmi Prasanna from COE Karimnagar, and then she started speaking about Shakespeare and Homer's Odyssey. So something which is
yes, only the literature students speak.
All literature students.
Yeah, yes, of course.
So
yes.
Very few literature students can speak about Shakespeare and then Homer's Odyssey and so on and so forth. So that is the kind of interest that is being shown by the students. So why not we thought why not introduce English Doctor again, and to revive the English speaking skills. For example, the lady who is sitting next to me, Geeta Lakshmi Garu. So all through her graduation, she has been studying in only Telugu medium. Post-graduation also in Telugu medium. But today, she did not even utter a single word in Telugu. And see her English, very stylish, very perfect and absolutely no grammatical mistakes. So I want to ask Geeta Lakshmi, how did you pick up this language?
Yeah, I think that's a very good question.
We'll
yes,
be,
yes,
we'll
yes.
be, we'll be out, our viewers will be, our students will be strong. Doubly benefited, particularly as teachers. So can you please share your secrets of success, ma'am?
Yes, sir. My journey as a student is really, it's a very difficult one, sir. Till fifth class, I don't know ABCD. I don't know even Telugu also. I don't know. Because I met with a fire accident, and ours is a very big large family. They sent me to a village to take care by someone. That's why it was like till fifth class I don't know anything. After that I came to Hyderabad and I started studying. One year, one school I changed. I studied in five schools. After coming to Holy Mary School, I joined at 9th and 10th, I studied in one school.
Okay.
That is Holy Mary School, and slowly then I started studying. Till then, I don't know, I didn't study anything. I started the studying. After that, I studied in Vanita Mahavidyalaya. There, to my surprise, I got General Proficiency Prize.
Wow.
That encouraged me a lot. Frankly speaking, I started speaking English after coming you only, sir. that credit goes to you only.
So that is, see, practice makes a man or woman perfect. So that is what Geeta Lakshmi's trajectory, life's trajectory or history tells us. So I think this is a wonderful lesson. So you don't have to learn from anyone who is, 2,000 or 12,000 kilometers away. So right next to us, here is a lady who is Geeta Lakshmi, whose life has been peaks and valleys, but still she ensured that she will go only up.
Okay. Yes.
All right.
And so you were talking about E plus. And what about the M plus and P plus? Are they going to continue this year as well?
Absolutely. M plus and E plus will continue, and then they will continue with renewed vigor. But only one thing I want to caution all the people who are doing M plus and E plus, M plus and P plus, physics plus. So ensure that you concentrate on application aspect. So while you try to get the conceptual clarity, it is very easy to memorize the concepts. It is very easy to memorize the formulae. It is very easy to write them on a piece of paper, but it is extremely difficult to apply. So my request to all the teachers is give as many real life situations as possible so that the students can apply the concepts in the real life situations, and then don't start with complex concepts. My request to all the teachers and then JLs who are handling both the sections, both the high school sections and then the, you know, the intermediate sections and degree college as well. So always try to start with simple concepts like friction, like the force, like the resistance, or like the basic atomic structure, like the, you know, the other hybridization, whatnot. Start with the simpler concepts. Don't go to the difficult concepts and then confuse the students. So once you start with simpler concepts, then the students will start developing these skills on their own. You don't have to worry about that. It is like taking a solid iron ball to the top of the hill. After that, you don't have to take it down again. You just push it from top of the hill. It will come on its own by gravitational force. So till such time, you should be working against the forces of gravity. So you have to really help the students to simpler, step by step, one step after another, one step after another. I see a lot of school walls painted with a lot of formulae, but students do not know how that formula is going to help them, how that formula are going to help them in their real life. So I want the teachers to to work on this aspect very well. Similarly, my request to all the school principals and then college principals and the teachers, don't look for direction from head office again and again. We are not gods. We are not goddesses.
Junior, senior vice principal.
Yeah. So now we have a junior vice principal and then senior vice principal. My request is, don't look for the direction from head office. Sir, I need a circular on this. I need a memo on this. I need a Mana TV talk on this. I need one teleconference on this. No. Your students are the children of great competence. They have tremendous power. Our Malawat Purna, Anand Kumar, and all other people, Sundar Raju, and all these people have demonstrated beyond a point, beyond your comprehension, that they are capable people. They are very much capable. Yesterday we spoke to Ajim Prem University students. They have grown so far, they have gone beyond our imagination. So our students are capable. You sit with the students. You decide what you have to learn. You decide what you have to teach. You decide how you have to teach. So I'm very happy that George and Geeta Lakshmi have been talking about a flipped classroom. See, flipped classroom is very simple, very, very simple. It is handing over half of your power to the students. You generally listen in the classroom and you don't talk. Very few people talk in the classroom. And you go back to your dormitories, you take rest for a while and then you come back to study hours and then again you look at the books. You don't do anything else or you do a little bit of homework. In flipped classroom, it is reverse. You do your homework in the classroom and you do your studies in the dormitory or in the study hours, in the evenings. So, for example, tomorrow I am going to teach you friction, or tomorrow I am going to teach you the Indian struggle for independence, or 1857 Sepoy mutiny. So, today itself, or day before yesterday, or today itself, I read what I am going to be taught tomorrow. So, I will read and then I will make notes on these things as a student or as a group of students. So, then we go as a group and then we, our teacher will initiate a discussion in the classroom. And all of us, we will tell all our perspectives based on what we had read in the dormitories or in the study hours. And we take the notes and then we start discussing with the colleagues. And teacher will only orchestrate the entire discussion, will monitor and orchestrate the entire discussion. And in the last 5 minutes, first 5 minutes or 10 minutes, she will initiate. And the next 20 minutes, the students will discuss the fight. And then there will be a lot of emotional disturbance in the classroom. Some people will be crying as well. And in the last 10 minutes or last 5 minutes, teacher will summarize. So here what happens is students will get more power or more opportunity to speak. And there shall not be any writing in the classroom. No writing answers on the blackboard. Teacher will face students more rather than showing her back or his back. So students will be faced at each other and there will be a lot of group fights. And later they will come with a new perspective. And after this there will be weekly testing. In weekly testing you will have to answer. Similarly, yes, there will be assignments. A lot of assignments, lot of assignments, and assignments will make you very powerful. Even, let me tell you, even in universities also there is no assignment system. But today, we in social welfare and tribal welfare resident schools, we are introducing assignment system, and only within the syllabus. Most of the time, your teachers will say, sir, if you introduce all these activities, then I won't be able to complete the syllabus. What is syllabus here? What is syllabus? Syllabus is nothing but a group of topics which have to be completed in particular year. Now we have introduced a concept called low hanging fruits and high hanging fruits. Low hanging fruits are nothing but the simpler concepts which children can teach themselves with the help of teacher, little bit help. High hanging fruits are the complex topics which children may not be able to do on their own. Those things teacher has to teach. So with this, what happens is teacher doesn't have to shout again, 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 again. Then there is a limit for shouting. How many hours can you speak, my dear teachers? Please think about it. It is in your own interest. We have decided to hand over the power to speak in the classrooms to students, so that the students also will get benefited and teacher also will get benefited. Similarly, Geeta Lakshmi has just spoken about weekly testing. Teachers will immediately say, sir, in weekly testing, if I conduct this, how many times do I have to correct these question papers? Who is asking you to correct all the question papers on your own? Select the teaching assistants in your classrooms who are capable of looking at the question papers, answer scripts, and then give them the guidelines so that they can do it on their own, or prepare buddy pairs. And then if I write an examination and then she writes examination, and she will give her answer script to me and then I'll give my answer script to her, and then you dictate the answers and then the job is over. And why are you giving 10 questions per weekly test? Give only 5 questions. And 5 questions based on the application aspect. So these are some of the simpler things, but they will make profound impact on the way you learn in the classrooms. So this is what makes you extremely powerful, my dear friends. So this is one of the things that we thought we should be introducing. So M plus and P plus, they will go with much more gusto. And then E plus also will be a revised version, the version 2, E plus 2.0, M plus 2.0, then P plus 2.0 and English Doctor 2.0. So all the version will be upgraded, and I think children will definitely enjoy.
Yes, I think children also given some personal diary as well.
Yes,
I forgot. Yeah, it's going to be really, really super. Even this year, friends, we are going to hand over one small, little, cute personal diary to you. Personal diary to write about your impressions, your personal impressions. I felt so happy today. The weather was so nice. My teacher, I liked my teacher's dress today. I like really her hairstyle. So my friends and I, we discussed about so many brilliant things today. And then I am, for record sake, I am keeping all these things in my personal diary. It is purely personal diary. Nobody will have access to your personal diary except to your house parent. So, and then your house parent, we are taking an undertaking, whatever she sees in your personal diary, she will not share with your colleagues. She will not share with your parents also. So, it is your purely personal diary. We are going to respect your privacy, and your privacy is more important than life for us. So, we are going to protect your privacy. You may be having some problems. So, you have to, you may be having some positive feelings and negative feelings. All those feelings, you must, we encourage you to write in those personal diaries, preferably in English, in your personal diaries, and you have to keep them protected in a very protected manner in your personal lock and
yes,
key.
Yes, it is their own feelings, they jot down their own feelings.
Absolutely.
So, but I don't think they should be able to write some their timetable, homework and all that, something like that?
No. Okay. Personal diary is not for timetable. Uh-huh. Personal diary is not for the science you learn in the classroom.
Yes.
Personal diary is about touching your soul, your heart, your
feelings,
mind,
yeah,
your experience.
Yeah.
On that particular day, for example, June 30th, I woke up with so many good thoughts. I had a dream of walking towards moon. And I was sitting in the classroom, and then suddenly somebody came from another planet, and then he came to me, and then he touched me, and then he just lifted me, and I was just walking towards moon. What a wonderful dream. So I woke up with this dream. You write the dream in your diary. That is what it is.
Yes, I think
so today you tasted nice food. So a wonderful menu has been given to you. So when I was tasting that chicken, so this is what I felt. When I was in my home, so I was only, you know, taking the flavor of chicken, but I never had the opportunity of taking chicken. But today, my cook has cooked such a wonderful chicken for me. So I felt like
bad experiences.
I think you have given a lot of clues on how to write a diary.
Yeah,
that is
exactly.
That's very
so
good.
Write your
yeah.
personal experiences, purely personal experiences. Don't copy from others. So there is another thing. This year onwards, we are going to declare copying as murder. I repeat, copying as murder. Copying as a violent crime. So if you copy from others, you are committing a murder. Please don't do it. It is going to be an offense. Copying from others is an offense. Copying from textbooks in toto is offense, is like murder. So don't do it. Similarly, copying dairy from others is also murder.
Yes.
So oka vyaktini copy kottadam ante oka vyaktini jeeva sajeevanga unnapude champadam lantidi. So please don't do it. It is like murder. So whether you write examinations, write in your own words. If you find it difficult, your teacher will help you. If teacher doesn't help you, then go to your colleague. Go to school council leader, go to someone else, or try to find out on your own, but don't copy. Copy is murder.
Yeah. Yes. I think all our Swaros have secured admissions in most of the prestigious universities in southern part of India. So are we also having planning to get admission to any northern prestigious universities?
Yes, this time I think by the vision of our secretary and by the support given by him, we have seen that good number, 242 students over the state of Telangana from our schools have scored more than 95%, sir. So these children, we ask them through their principals whether they are interested in getting into one of the prestigious university, that is Delhi University, which is a platform also to get into the syllabus is designed in such a way that half the work is done. If we get graduation in that university, IPS and IAS, UPS examination is very easy for them when compared to others. And there in Delhi University, to understand about the culture and the academics and admission, we called two of our children to head office along with this 40 children who wanted to get admission in the university. Then there was a special procedure of calculating their percentile also. So we have done it, and I think to my knowledge 30 children we have identified to get into Delhi University comfortably. So on 23rd evening or 24th morning we are going to get the cutoffs of various colleges in Delhi, affiliated to Delhi University. So I think probably we are waiting for the willingness from the principals and the children. So we are planning to take them to Delhi and give them admission there. So I think they will have the right platform, and society will be the air under their wings, and that platform they can become IAS and IPS more comfortably when compared to the other children.
But Rupaji, I wanted to ask you, will it not be costing more? So
yeah,
you might ask
that's
this
a,
question.
That's a very good question. I think he has initiated. Getting into prestigious universities is going to be costly. Is it happening to us also?
No,
sir. Does it cost to the Swaros?
No, sir. I think we have spoken to two of our students, Puneet and Namrata. They have told that fees is quite nominal.
Mm-hmm.
Only we will have one difficulty, that is accommodating the students.
Ah, yeah.
So, when there are some institutions which are having hostels attached to them,
mm-hmm.
and the hostel will be given only on basing of the merit. So, the percentile which we have calculated is 98 and 97.
Mm-hmm.
So, I believe that in the first cutoff only our children may get in admissions, but we also have to struggle a little for this hostel.
Okay.
That is I think a constraint which we have to face. Otherwise fees is quite nominal. They were telling it is ranging from 11,000 rupees to some 40,000 rupees. They were telling like that.
Very nice.
But I think we are calculating everything, and one person we have taken into confidence. They are going to help us in locating ourselves in Delhi, sir. And we will talk to the vice chancellors and registrars also, that to what extent our children can get accommodation in the hostels. There are some institutions which are residential as well, sir. So, for example, Miranda House is there. Joseph and Mary institution is there. They are having hostels, sir. And some institutions which are hostel, we will look into that. And if hostel is not attached, then they are having this guest GP also is there, sir. Ante PG, I mean to say, the paying guest system also is there. That is a bit costly, because it ranges from 10,000 to even 15,000, 20,000 like that, depending upon the food and accommodation the children are going to get there. So I think we have to work out minute details, but our children are highly eligible to get admission into that Delhi University.
Yes.
And I think it is a good thing that we are starting, sir. As we have started in Azim Premji with one step, I think now we are successfully getting the third batch of students. Similarly, if two or three of our students are there, they will be the motivating factor for others to walk into that prestigious university.
Yes, sir. Now, viewers, let me also welcome Mr. Sharma, who is our MANATV coordinator. Mr. Sharma, welcome to this show.
Thank you, sir.
I think you have been instrumental in preparing the students for competitive examination under the direction of our secretary. What do you would like to say about this competitive spirit of the students and this competitive examinations, and also the entry of students into different prestigious universities? What is your opinion about this?
Good afternoon, all of you, my viewers. As all of you know that our secretary sir has been floating so many academic initiatives for the last 5 years. So among those academic initiatives, Super Students program is one, and it is very successful, like E plus program. The students who were selected school, district level and the state level, they were excelling not only in Super Students program, they were performing well as teaching assistants as well as green gurus in our institutions. So apart from these success, these super students are performing well and getting admissions into prestigious universities yes. like Ajim Premji University, Central Universities, HCU, IFLU, like other universities. Yes. Like now we are entering into the Delhi doorstep University. Of Delhi University Delhi. Also. So it's a wonderful achievement, accomplishment. So these now these super student programs are also extended to degree colleges this year from this year.
Yes.
So it's a wonderful achievement. We are providing so many training programs to the super to the students who are appearing for competitive examinations of different universities and the institutions. This is one of the success of this super student program, and we are the secretary sir is also going to unveil the advanced version of super student program very shortly on the similar lines of TEDx. We are happy to hear about that new program sir.
Yes, TEDx.
TEDx. So thank you Sharma, that is a very good opinion you talked about the entry of students into prestigious colleges. Now let us hear from our secretary, what are the new initiative we are going to have in the degree colleges?
Yeah, this year we will also be introducing in degree colleges have really brought us a lot of fame at a shortest possible time, so we are very happy about it. So this year we are planning to introduce driving for degree college girls. So we will be teaching driving, four wheeler driving to our degree college girls, so that when they go out of the college as graduates or as undergraduates, and then when they join the universities and when they join the jobs or otherwise also when they start the business of their own, and we will be they will be they will not find it very difficult to acquire a car.
Yes.
So I want all our girls to learn driving, four wheeler driving, so that they can they can own a car. Then similarly we also want to teach biking to all our girls, like why should girls only drive ride scooters, why not bullet motorcycles? So that's why we want to teach a few of girls who are very robust and then very active and strong. So such girls will be taught riding the bikes. We start with the Hero Honda or we start with any other normal 150 cc bikes, and slowly we will migrate to Bajaj Pulsars, and then slowly we will also reach Bullet 355 Royal 350 cc Royal Enfield bikes. So we will we are very particular about this aspect, because we don't want women's to be we don't want women to be recklessly stereotyped. And the third important thing which we are going to teach degree colleges is entrepreneurial skills. Why should always we think about government jobs or private jobs? Why can't we start a company of our own? Now I know some of the Sweros who are making crores of rupees business, they have been very nominal. They never got 90% and above in their student life, and some of them they have failed in graduation. But what they really learnt is, how do we make money? How do we start a business? How do we make a qualitative product? And then how do we market that product? So how do we have that kind of convincing skills? So all these business tactics we are going to teach our students, particularly the degree college students. Similarly, we have English doctor, this year we will also be introducing a program on Money TV called Money Maker. So in Money Maker, you will be taught as to how to save money, how to save money, how to invest that money in your life, and how to create money when you go out of colleges, and how to not to waste money, how to not get cheated by others in the market. So these are the some of the things which we will be teaching them in Money Maker program. Like you are English doctor, we have a Money Maker. So these Money Maker programs also we will be introducing in Mana TV. Similarly, we have already taught a lot of children about different hairstyles. In fact, my son went to Shakepet school and got his hair cut, and then unfortunately I don't have any hair to get cut. So anyway, my wife also, she visited Narsinghe Social Welfare Residential School, and she was really amazed at the way our girls were creating different hairstyles. So I am really bored of the hairstyle in the social welfare residential schools. Only two plaits always.
It's a part of a life skill.
Yeah, maybe. So this year we have trained about 100 or 200 students in different hairstyles. I wish these students, and we are going to provide a lot of machines to different schools to try different hairstyles. So, but this will be an interesting concept, and then I think our students will be very interested to learn all these things.
So, it's almost like if the girls wants to learn biking or driving, join residential school degree colleges.
As a hobby.
As a hobby.
As a serious hobby. Similarly, on degree colleges front, we are proposing 10 degree colleges for boys as well, because our boys have been crying. As such, our society is dominated by girls.
Girls, yes.
So, boys have been crying, sir, please, our chief minister was kind enough to give at least a consent. For tribal welfare, he's already given. So, consent to social welfare residential degree college for boys as well. And then similarly, we are also going to propose to the government that can we start a college of nursing as well, nursing and fine arts college. And similarly, we have started 4 colleges of excellence in degree colleges stream. So, one is exclusively for civil services, second is for advanced mathematics and physical sciences, and third one is for biological sciences, and fourth one is for business, trade and commerce.
Yes, yes.
So, in future, you have Mukesh Ambani type of people,
Satya Nadella,
Sundar Pichai, and whatnot will be coming from social welfare and tribal welfare residential schools.
Yep.
And similarly, you have Shreya Ghoshal, then Shreya Ghoshal and Arjit Singh and other people from our fine arts colleges.
Are we also planning to start some signing schools, something like that?
It's a very good question. It is in the pipeline, and we have already contacted Korukonda Sainik School, and our minister is also extremely happy about this project. Our special chief secretary Ajay Mishra Garu, and then our Benhar Rekka Garu, all these people are very happy about the Sainik School kind of thing. Shortly, we will be going to Korukonda and other Sainik schools in the country, and then we will be picking up the best practices, and then we want to convert one school in social welfare and then another school in tribal welfare as preparatory Sainik schools. So, we may not be able to mash the Sainik schools in the near, immediately, but definitely we will be having a Sainik school where we select children after a lot of testing. And there will be swimming pools, there will be horse riding, activities in the Sainik schools. And similarly, for those people who are very much interested in cricket, this year we will be starting 4 cricket academies, 2 for social welfare and then 2 for tribal welfare and 1 for girls and then 1 for boys. And then where we can create as many Sachin Tendulkars and then Mithali Raj as possible in our schools. And then, my dear Sveros, future belongs to you. Don't worry about it. We are trying day and night, and then we are having sleepless nights, but all these things will help you grow as great, great, great individuals.
I think Mr. Sharma would like to add
Sir, there is plenty of options with regard to education and employment in defense area.
Yes.
You are providing so many opportunities to boys with NDA training,
yes,
and TIS training.
Yes.
But the boys are not coming forward to opt this option and use this opportunity. Can you address any reason?
Yes. It's my privilege, Dr. Sharma. So, it is really very sad to see that our boys are not interested. So, many people are... you are after engineering, you do BTEC. After that, many BTEC engineers are coming to me for data entry operator job, the salary for which is just 14,000 rupees. What will you do with 14,000 rupees? So, engineering or nursing, after graduation also you can pursue army as a career. So, Indian army is one of the biggest employers in this world, and the facilities that Indian army gives are phenomenal. For example, one soap outside market, it costs about 20 rupees. In Indian army, it costs only 2 rupees, because it is, everything is subsidized. And once you join Indian army as an officer, sky is the limit for you to grow. Like, you can become a pilot, you can become a captain of a destroyer ship, you can become an infantry person, and the kind of the pride and freedom and the honor you get in Indian Army is nothing compared to, it cannot be compared to any job in this the nation. So, and it teaches you a lot of discipline and it makes you very tough, and you don't have to serve all through your lifetime in Indian Army. So, after 20 years you can always take a retirement and then join the private sector, join the, you know, police forces, join the
government
sector as well. So, joining Indian Army, you know, fighter pilot, and then suppose if you are a fighter pilot, after 20 years, after 15 years, you can retire from fighter pilot and then you can become the members of, you know, commercial, pilot of commercial airlines. So, you can fly a big commercial planes. Similarly, this year, we are planning to, we have already encouraged a lot of children to join military nursing services, girls particularly. So, similarly, we will be encouraging a lot of children to join, you know, other, you know, defense service forces, the forces, the jobs which are related to defense services. So, defense, military, army, navy, air force as an option is a very important thing for our sweros. You have all that capability, all you need is a little bit of life skill. Similarly, in degree colleges, we are also going to introduce air hostess. We are going to select a lot of people for air hostess job, and we will be training them in Franklin Institute in Hyderabad. And then if 3 to 4 people are lucky enough to get into air hostess, and then that will open a new vista for our sweros.
Yes, the sweros are going to,
yeah, they can, you can literally fly in the sky. Yeah, the salary of air hostess starts from about 60,000, and it goes up to 3 lakhs, 4 lakhs. You can fly international airlines. And then airlines is going to be a very important industry in future, and then lot of planes companies are buying, and then, you know, the sky is the limit, my dear friends. Don't restrict yourself to 2 to 3 jobs. Similarly, in every school, we are going to construct a huge wall of fame, wall of fame. All the successful sweros, their names will be, we will be inscribing their names on those granite walls, and they will stay for 100 years in the schools. All the youngsters will see their names, who are successful, again, who are not those people who are failures. Successful, we are going to keep them in thing. Another thing I wanted to tell you, next year onwards, in intermediate admissions, we are not going to follow 60% reservation for social welfare or tribal welfare. So, what we are going to do is, we are going to select anybody, any person who gets the best marks into social welfare residential
within
schools.
The caste.
Within the same caste. Within the SCs, we are going to select the best people if they are from this school or this school, other school. So, my request is, please concentrate on your marks. I don't want from anyone from social welfare and then tribal welfare to lag behind in getting the marks. So, even those 10 people also, they should not, you know, fail. And similarly, your grade point should be always above 8%. And then I request all the principals and the teachers to identify those people who are going to fail now itself. And 7th class, 8th class, 9th class, the people who are facing difficulty, identify them. We will have a special program for them. You have to devise a special program for those people who are going to fail or who are going to face the difficulty in their
During this summer, some of our girls were taught self-defense techniques. What are we going to do for them? Any further program for them, girls?
Yes. These girls who have been taught self-defense, kata, then punch. So, these people, so they will be teaching their school colleagues. And then if anybody is found to be outstandingly good in teaching the life-saving skills or self-defense techniques, we will pay that student, grading them, we will be grading them, and then if somebody is outstanding, we will be paying them some salary.
I think we
well.
Have 4 brown belt holders,
yeah.
Karatekas.
Yeah, so not 400, not 4, 400. So, we have trained 400
okay,
people.
400, yes.
So, these 400 people will be going into different schools, and then they will be teaching then self-defense techniques, punch, then block, all these things, and if they are found to be very useful and outstanding, we are going to pay them monthly salary.
Yo,
so they are going to earn money while they earn.
Any belt holders are there?
We have brown belt holders, and then slowly we will ensure that all of them become black belt as well.
Sir, then again coming to a little bit of training aspects of it. Come August, TSPC is conducting recruitment drive now. So come August, we have a huge army of teachers descending on our schools.
Yes.
What we plan to do for them?
Yeah. So, we, it's a good news for all the students who have been facing the shortage of teachers. So our Telangana State Public Service Commission is going to recruit about 3,500 teachers for social welfare and tribal welfare this year. So that is a huge thing. We should thank our Chief Minister from bottom of our hearts that we have been facing a huge challenge of good teachers. So by first examination is already over in July. By July 30th, all the examinations will be over. So in August first week, they will be landing in our schools, and we will be training them in a very different fashion. So first 1 week they will be trained institutionally, and then second 1 week they will be attached to different well-performing schools, and again a third week they will be brought back to the institutions, the training institutions, and this we call it as a sandwiched training. And after that they will be sent to different schools basing on the requirement. So similarly, it, in a week or in a week from now, we will be promoting about 100 people as principals in social welfare, and then we have already promoted people in tribal welfare as a principal. So the shortage of manpower is going to come down, and you are going to see a lot of new faces in your schools as teachers. And by then, you, most of you, so my request is, in this period, there are a lot of transition. So a lot of TGTs will become PGTs, and PGTs will become JLs, and they will be going to different schools. So my request to all the students, particularly the senior students, to not to lose focus. So you are already, you have been taught as to how to teach yourself. So this is the responsibility of the principal as well. So the students have to teach themselves. If you depend too much on your teachers, the teacher will go to different school after promotion. I don't want you to cry. So I want you to stay put. I won't, we will be sending a micro schedules. So I want you to stay put, and then I want you to continue the learning process till the new teachers come, and then till the vacancies are filled up. So don't ever, if teacher is not there, don't waste those 40 minutes. This is my request. If teacher is transferred, don't get shocked. Get ready for those shocks, because we are, they have to get promoted, and they have to go to new places of their posting. We cannot put a person say in the same place for you know, so many years, even after promotion. So these are the things that are going to be inevitable in our
Are we also planning to continue with teaching assistants?
Of course, yes. We are going to planning to have teaching assistants, green gurus,
okay. Green gurus
and
yes.
Super students. All these people have to continue the learning process, and they have to teach their juniors. They have to teach their colleagues in groups and in different classes. So this is going to be extraordinary shift in our schools, yes, this year.
Are there any additional teachers for class 5 this year?
We are planning, yes. I think there will be some additional teachers.
We have already added three teachers.
And we will give instructions to the principals as well.
Yes, sir. And we have a specialized colleges, schools, and we have many courses added. But I think we need to take care of their energy level as well. So do we have any news in that area as well?
So we have a new menu. You are referring to new menu. Yes,
that's good.
This is the most exciting thing. Huh. So we used to give around 2 to 3 times chicken in a month. But this year onwards, we are going to give you at least 4 times chicken and then 2 times mutton. So which I did not have as a student. So although my parents were teachers, but we did not have the luxury of eating chicken or mutton so heavily. So but we want you to grow with a lot of healthy food. And similarly, we are going to give ghee in your lunches. So you will have food with ghee, nice ghee, so that you can eat well. And third thing is we are going to give you a lot of new snacks. And we are also going to experiment with the chapatis and puris this year. So we are making preparations for all those things, and we have already communicated the menu to all the schools. And it is going to be a very important and nutritious menu for all of you. And my only request to all the students is don't waste food. I see many of the girls are not eating eggs in the name of zero size. That zero size is a myth. So eat well, and read well, and sleep well. If you don't
play
eat
well.
And play well, and yes. Whatever you eat, you must be able to spend that energy, that food on the ground. If you don't eat well, then how are you going to? So the science says the people who do not eat well in their childhood will become stunted in when they grow. Their knowledge, their brains will not function according to the full capacity. They won't function up to the full capacity. So my request is eat well. But once you eat, you should be able to work well. on the ground as well as in the classrooms, outside the classrooms, inside the classrooms. So, walk well and do not sit for a longer time and do not sleep for too many hours. Okay. So, this is one brilliant thing that we are introducing this year is a menu, revised menu.
Yes.
And it is going to be super important in our schools. Similarly, this year onwards, we are going to check your weight gain. So, every quarter at least should be some weight gain, biomass, body mass index. So, if you do not gain 1 kg extra weight, especially when you are younger, we are going to give a memo to your principals. Similarly, we are going to see your height gain. So, there should be some increment in your height as well. So, these are some of the important things that we are going to introduce in your schools this year. Similarly, we are going to train your parents. So, we have already trained thousands of parents in summer, and similarly, this summer, this year also, we are going to train your parents. See, I think we are getting closer.
I think this new menu is a really, really good news for all the Swaros. But what we observe, sir, there is a lot of wastage is going on at the dining hall. So, what do you have to say, advice to the students? There, I think a lot of wastage is there in the
I think one of the important reasons for this wastage is lack of planning and then lack of proper preparation. So, this year by this weekend or next week, we are going to train all our cooks and catering contractors as to how to cook a good food. In Hyderabad, we are going to call all of them and we are going to train them with all the expert cooks from different star hotels and then catering services and help them to pick up the skills of good cooking. That is number one. Number two, we are encouraging children to serve themselves. So, we are going to give lot of utensils wherever it is required and then children can put all that food in the buckets or the vessels and put them on the table and then they can serve themselves so that the wastage of the food will come down drastically. So, this is another thing that we have already experimented in Mahendrails and Sheikhpet. It really worked wonders and then we want every school to experiment with self-serving as well. So, I think the school leadership has been very ineffective so far. They could not make any their presence felt. So, my request is the principals to please give more powers to school leaders, school councils, house-wise and then leadership-wise, the school-wise, give more powers to these school leaders so that they can gain the skill of running the schools on their own. This is what we want from all the principals.
Yes, sir. Sir, good advice, sir. Now, June 5th, we all celebrated World Environment Day.
Yeah.
What is our contribution, our schools, society's contribution towards the environment?
See, one of the important things is harvest rainwater. Don't allow it to go to the outside. So, ensure that it seeps into your own ground, rain harvesting pits. Then second thing is plant as many trees as possible. Telangana government is extremely particular about Haritaharam. So, make Haritaharam like last year, you could all schools put together social welfare and tribal welfare about 1.5 lakhs. This year all the schools put together, we have to have 3 lakh trees planted in all our schools. So, this year this is the target for all the principals and then the teachers. So, don't have any let up on these issues and once you plant the trees, so ensure that they are protected. Just don't plant the trees for the secretary's sake or the record sake or Facebook's sake. So, plant the trees properly and then protect them. So, because they are going to protect you in future. Global warming is a serious thing. So, global warming, if we do like this, we are going to die in the next 100 years.
Yes.
So, this is a serious specter.
Very serious issue.
Very serious issue. We may die, but you are going to live and your children are going to live and your grandchildren are going to live. What kind of planet you are going to give them? See, something which you should look into. Yeah.
Yes, sir. And as the days go by, we are also slowly getting into digital mode.
Yes.
As part of paperless office.
Yes.
So, what are our plans in that? Observation, classroom observation by the principal?
Yes. We have introduced a new format for classroom observation and then it's going to be a very important thing. And then we have already given tablets to principals and then they have to feed the data. They have to feed the data about classroom what they see every week, at least 2 people have to be watched by the principal and then she has to put all the observations of that particular teacher in the classroom observation format and then that data will come to head office. And similarly, Panacea Command Center is going to work with full steam and similarly, we are going to have an independent inspectorate of schools and where we are going to hire a lot of retired people and then they will be surprising the schools, and then they will be announcing that they would be coming, and then they will be sitting in the classrooms and then observe, and then they will also be looking into the cleanliness in the toilets and so on and so forth. So a lot of things are going to happen this year anyway. So this year going to be as usual. 17-18 is going to be very, very exciting.
We are going to be very, very active with a lot of new initiatives. I think it is time that we wind up the program. So let me ask all of my colleagues who are sitting here, including the secretary, what is their message for this new academic year? So let me start with Dr. Sharma, the Mana TV coordinator.
So there are so many opportunities before you. Use them, excel them.
That's a very good message. Thank you, Dr. Sharma, and madam.
I believe in planning is half done. So as a team, as a school leader, principal, junior vice principal, and senior vice principal, you sit together and plan for the academic excellence of the students and all round development of the students.
Thank you, ma'am. That's very good message. Now over to you, ma'am.
Sir, I want to give a message to the people there is, they have to work with the team spirit. They have to analyze the last year's work. They have to optimize in everything, and they have to have a set goals for sports, for academics, for co-curricular activities, form groups and give responsibility to everybody, recognize the students according to their potential and make them be proud of the school. The school should be proud of the children and the children should be proud of their school.
Thank you, ma'am. That's very good. I think now it is my chance to wish you all the best. My message would be, most of us thought that all these initiatives will not happen. We did it. Last year, we did it with NQP, presentation by the teachers. And this year, we said flipped class is almost impossible. But we realized that at the end of 4 days training, that our teachers, the master trainers themselves came up and said, yes, it is possible, sir. So I would request all the teachers and the students, nothing is impossible if there is a will. So let us work towards that and let us achieve the impossible, and sky is the limit for us. So now it is over to again our secretary for the final wind up and his message for the day, for the this academic year.
See, my only message, you know me and then I know you very intimately. So my only message is keep dreaming, keep working.
Keep
and achieving. Future is yours, undoubtedly yours. Never ever give up. You are not inferior to anyone. And then never forget your 10 commandments. I repeat, keep dreaming, keep working, and never give up. Thank you so much. I wish you a very, very happy, a wonderful, eventful, impactful, and the most successful academic year 2017 and 18. I wish all the best. Thank you.
So I thank Dr. Sharma, Mrs. Geeta Lakshmi, Mrs. Rupa Devi, and our secretary for joining this Mr. Sudhakar for joining this program, the very first of its kind in the academic year. And I'm sure that we will again meet with more and more initiative through Mana TV and reach out to all of you. So wish you all the best from all of us from the studio. Thank you very much for watching this show.